Hello and welcome to Tech. I am Mohammed Adnan and in this video we are going to discuss about how to bring back your confidence in making of a sales dashboard. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Now let's get started. Many of the people have approached me that they have knowledge of Power BI. They'll get the certification of the Power BI, but they are not much confidence about how to make a real-time dashboard. For that, what they feel is they don't have the domain knowledge of it. Say for example, if they want to make a sales dashboard, and what are the parameters they need to look at it, and what are the things they need to consider while preparing the sales dashboard. These are the things which they are not aware of it. So that what I thought is to make a video about it so everybody can get a knowledge of how to prepare the sales dashboard. So let's have a look at the detail. The agenda is what is sales and types of sales, how to build an effective sales dashboard, what consists of a sales dashboard. What is sales? Sales is a term used to describe the activities that leads to the selling of goods or service. There are three main categories in the sales. One is the region where they are selling, whether they are selling in USA or India or Australia, which location they are selling, we need to get that information. And the product or service they are selling, product in the sales, if they are selling the mobile phones or a laptop bag or laptops, or any other stationary items like that, or a service. Service in the sense is consulting services or teaching services are there. This all comes under the services. And the target customer, to which they need to focus on. If they are selling a mobile phone, then they have to target the young audience, not the aged persons. And if they are selling the toys, they have to target the kids, not the young audience or the aged peoples. So those things they need to consider. And there are types of sales here, four types actually. So let's go one by one. One is offering of the sales, whether it is product or service. Like said before, product like a laptop or mobile phones or stationary items, something like that. And services is like consulting charges and teaching services, etc. The target audience is B2B, is business to business. That is, the manufacturer will transfer it to wholesaler, or the manufacturing going to transfer to the direct customer, the B2C, business to the customer. And how the sales is performed, whether it is inside sales or an outside sales. Inside sales is nothing but the telecalling, what I do from inside the office. And outside sales is the physical marketing. People will go door to door and they will sell the product or services. It is like the people who are, if they are in medical line, so the people will come to the doctor, they will sell the product directly, they will sell their medicine directly to the doctor. This is how it is, the outside sales. If it is an inside sale, then we will get a call from an insurance company that these are the plans available, we can buy the insurance from them. So this all comes under the inside sales. And what are the channels they are used for the sales? Whether it is online, we can get an email from the person that these are the products and services we are offering, you can buy it from us. Or offline, the physical person visits to that and sell the product. Telesale, we get a call from the customer care of them. Affiliate marketing is someone is doing affiliate for the other's product. There are websites like Amazon, people are doing like that, affiliate programming as well. And outsource channel, so some person will give this job to the other company so that they can sell the product with the people on behalf of them. How to build an effective sales dashboard? So these are things we need to consider while preparing a sales dashboard. Who need to see this information? That is an important thing. Whether it is a CEO or CFO or a sales head, etc. And next thing is, what purpose does it serve? Analyze the sales performance. When it comes to sales, we have to analyze the performance and what we have achieved so far. Analyze the performance based on region, based on the product, based on the customer, or based on a person, etc. And next point to consider, how often will it be looked at? This information is going to look by the people daily, weekly, monthly, quarterly, or yearly. Based on that, we need to prepare the dashboard. And how much data should you include? Over what period of time, 1 year, 2 year, 5 year data you have to keep to analyze. The more you have the data, the more you can analyze the data as well. And the structured or unstructured data sources. If it's a structured data, then we can use the managed relationship and do the reporting. If it is unstructured data, then we have to do the ETL process, and then we have to create a relationship, and then we can build the dashboard over that. Before making any dashboard, first of all, we need to understand the data and understand the business logic and as well as the business process. To get into detail, let's take an example of the SQL Server Database AdventureWorks, which I used in this example. So it is basically manufactures and sells metals and composite bicycles to North America, Europe, and Asian commercial markets, while its base operation located in Bothell, Washington, with 290 employees. Several region sales teams are located throughout the marketplace. So this is the basic idea about this. Now let's have a look at the database table structure. So this is the report, and let's move on to the model. So I want to zoom it a bit. This is the fact internet sales, and this is the main fact table. And this fact table is connected to the master dimensions, that is, one is product, customer, currency, date table, territory, and promotions. So let's have a look in detail about the table, what are the data available. So this is the fact table. In this I have the product key, order date, due date key, ship date key, customer key, from here the customer link, promotion key, currency key, the promotion currency, and sales territory, sales order number, sales order line number, revision. So these are the quantities and units sold and the tax as well as. So these are the information which we have. Now based on that, what report we can prepare? So we can prepare the sales based on the sales territory. And also if you go to this customer master, this is the customer master table. In this I have the information of the customers, customer key, geography key, we can get the location of the customer, and date of birth is there, marital status is there, gender also is there, and total number of children and their educations, everything is there. So based on that, we can develop some kind of information which I can show you. So this is an example of a sales dashboard, what it consists of, a sales dashboard, and is taken an AdventureWorks, which is a cycle manufacturing company basically. So they had the total sales of 29 million here, I highlighted here, and the total sales order, total customer, total product they are selling, and total countries they are selling. So these are the date I have selected here, and these are sales performance year by year, in 2010, 2011, 12, 13, and 14, by each and every month. And these are sales by sales territory group in North America, in Pacific, and Europe. These are divided by region, in which region we have the highest sales here. Here we have North America, the highest sales. And again, the next is sales by category and territory. In which category we have the huge sales? In Europe we have heavy sales in bikes, whereas in North America it is in accessories, and in clothing it is also in North America. And move on to the next, sales by marital status, it is married or single. So people who are buying with this, most of them are married when compared to singles. And sales by gender, female or male, so it is almost both of them are same. And the next is sales by customer age, by What is the age of the customer to whom we are selling the products? It is the age person seems like, because 41 to 50, 51 to 60, those are the people who are making the top sales here. And sales by commute distance, at what distance they are coming to the shop? So actually they are coming from within a 1 mile. So the shop which is located is on the right place. This will help us. If the shop is not located on the right place, so users are coming from the long distance, so that we can plan to open a new shop nearby to the most of the users from where they are coming. And sales by territory and state. So United States have the highest sales, and then Australia, and then UK, and then Germany, France and Canada. So in this video I tried to explain what are the things you need to consider while making of the sales dashboard. If you like this concept and if you want me to do this more on other domain as well, like the project management, like the construction, like the manufacturing, like HR, what are the things you need to consider while making up these dashboards, then please click on the like button and also post your comments on the comment section below. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Share it with your friends and colleagues. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.